Good morning, Eddie. Thanks for joining us here in Chattanooga.
Oh, man. Thanks for taking time out for us today, brother.
How things going? You've been a little busy, man. 20 years. Can you believe you've been in this business 20 years now?
What's so funny about the whole deal is, me and T-Roy put this duo together. Nashville didn't. And, on a national scene, we've been together 20 years. But, me and T've been together over 30 years. And so, I was always, used to looking to my left, man, and having T-Roy right there. Because, with us, we come out of the honky-tonks in Kentucky, and what you see is what you get. And let me tell you, when September happened, September 8th happened, man, yep. A horrific accident, man, my whole world just changed. A piece of my heart left. And, we've known each other longer than we've known our wives.
Yeah.
And so, when that happened, man, I didn't know what was going on. I was just lost there for a while. And I want to thank, of course, we don't call nobody fans. We call them friends. And I can't thank all of our friends enough out there for all the cards and the letters and everything, man. Because that really got to me thinking and stuff. And then I remembered a conversation, man, that me and T-Roy had a while back. And, talking about, if either one of us ever go down, I want to make sure, man, that the other one wants to make sure. It's like, man, let's make sure that the MG brand keeps going.
Yeah.
And of course, we just had got done with the CD 2 days before the accident.
Just amazing.
And so, I was thinking about that whole thing where they put that. I'm like, all right, you know what? He was always about new music anyway.
Yeah.
And I mean, we could have cut a CD and have released a single, and he'd be going, all right, let's get back in the studio and cut a new CD. But I was like, T-Roy kicked my butt, man. If we didn't release this, CD, and we didn't go, and we didn't keep Montgomery Gentry brand going.
So that kind of hit.
I'm gonna do it.
Yeah. So that kind of hits on what I was going to ask. So that made that decision really easy for you, because you guys have actually had that conversation prior, and so the decision to continue on with Montgomery Gentry was a pretty easy one for you.
We did. The thing about it is, what's so funny about it? Because back then we was kind of joking around with it, because I always thought it. I thought it would be me first, because, on the wilder side and stuff, and, I never questioned the man upstairs, and, the thing about it is, life's short, and we always love to live every second of it. We have.
I tell you what, the Better Me, you guys put that out to radio shortly after T-Roy's death, and it touched me right away. I know that song has a special meaning for you, because it was the first song you guys put out after his passing, and it touched a lot of people, because the topic of that song, and it was a special one to T-Roy, right?
Oh, I'll tell you, it's what's funny and weird about that whole thing of that song especially, is all these years and stuff that we've been listening to songs and cutting songs, a lot of times me and T would be out, and we'd be running around, and I'd hear a song go like, not the MG song, but I hear T-Roy singing it, or he'd go like, got the MG song, but I hear Eddie singing. That's the first time he'd ever come to me after we heard that song, and he went, man, Eddie, I really want to sing that song.
Wow.
And so, I mean, it's really unreal.
He does an amazing job on it, and it was really great to hear that song come out. And it, like I said, it really touched me a lot. You guys have some, or you personally have some roots here in Chattanooga, or some connections to Chattanooga. My brother rides trains with Norfolk Southern. Evidently, Chattanooga to Danville is a direct shot on the rails, by the way.
Oh, yes. actually, my grandfather was Southern Railroad, and I got a son now that works for the railroad, just started for it, and he goes back for Chattanooga and stuff.
Hey, buddy, I appreciate you taking some time out for us this afternoon. Best of luck on this tour. We're looking forward to hearing the full album. Better Me, like I said, is a great song, and we've been proud to play it here on 107.9 Nash Icon, and happy to have you guys back out on the road.
All righty, brother. We appreciate you. Have a good day.
Thank you, Eddie. Take care, man.